I lay sprawled on the sweat-soaked bed of a dismal cheap hotel room, my guts long emptied and the sink stained from my heavings. I tremble and shiver, starting at every sound that echoes outside my door. My fit lies open beside me, the instruments of my relief. The spike, the blackened spoon, and the can of sterno. And I wait. I wait for the familiar figure to saunter through the door, with his hand extended, taking my money as he slips me my precious jolt of H. I've waited, but my pusher has not come.
Oh, God, God, where is he? I've got to have a fix. I've got to. Oh, if I don't hit up in score soon, I'll go out of my mind.
As I wait through the hours, my body racked with pain, my throat dry and burning, and my tongue fuzzy in my mouth, I think of how I first became a head, a user, a dope addict. A year ago, no, it was less than a year ago that I took a puff on my first rope.
I think I did okay. It was pretty tough. But, Sue, I was wondering if you'd be interested in going with me to the spring dance?
I don't think so.
Why? What's the matter?
Well, it's just that Chip Henderson already asked me to go.
Oh.
Don't spaz out, Eddie. It's not the end of the world. See you later.
It was that day that I was first turned on to Roach. Roaches. Jive tea, joint, a reefer, a marijuana cigarette. Most heads start with T and graduate to H or M, heroin or morphine. That's what happened to me. I was still going to Central High back then.
Hey, Eddie. Come on along, me and the clan are gonna blast a few of these.
What are they, Sid?
T, pot, Mary Jane, boo, you square, don't you pop this stuff yet?
Marijuana?
Cool it, you jerk. You want to get me twisted? Some narc may be pinning us. Come on, hop in.
Oh, no thanks, Sid. I'd rather not.
Oh, come on, Eddie. We're going to have a wig, a ball. Sue will be there. I know you like Sue.
Sue? Sue Minner? She smokes tea?
I couldn't believe it. Sue Minner smoking marijuana? I was crazy about Sue. I thought she was the prettiest girl at Central High.
Sue's okay, Eddie. She's real straight. She's on it. Sorry, you won't be joining up.
Oh, wait, Sid, I'm coming.
I figured it would be a good way to get friendly with Sue, so I went along. Sid took me to a dingy cellar clubhouse near the school.
Hey, Sid.
Hey, Sid, long time no see. What's the hospital, baby?
That roach I blasted while waiting for Sue Minner was my first marijuana cigarette. Sid watched me from across the room until I finished it. Sue never came, but by that time I didn't care. I was high.
Oh, shit, I'm blind. Give me another one.
So you see, I never realized it until it was much too late that Sid had lied to me about Sue, that she was never coming, and that he'd only given me that joint to get me started. I had forked over what was to be my first in a long series of payments for this stuff. I was hooked.
Hey, Bubba, you want to get a job right now?
That's kind of classic.
I'll work it out. Yeah. Combination.
Sid never looked for me after that. I looked for him, and it wasn't long before I was begging him for...
Something stronger, Sid. I don't get enough of a rise out of tea anymore.
I could get some pills, kid.
Pills, Sid?
Bee pills, devils, jackets. Ben's a dream, big.
I dig. Cool, whatever.
Okay.
And so I was promoted. Now I was a Benny head. A barbiturate head. A benzedrine addict.
Red or yellow, kid?
It doesn't matter, Sid. Either one. I need it bad. Just gimme.
Oh, red.
Hey, Sid! Some kids here to see ya.
Yeah, more. Send them in.
And then, it was only natural that I graduated to...
Oh, Sid, I need eight!
10. Okay, kid, but it'll cost ya.
Yeah,
$2 a jolt and a fin for the fit.
That's it. Cool. Whatever it costs.
What do you got?
Okay.
Just give me.
I got a pair.
Not good enough.
It had taken me less than 3 months to go from blasting Jive T to popping H. It seemed that my every waking hour was spent somewhere waiting for Sid, my connection. I was on it.
Oh, Sid, thank God you're here. I need it fixed. Here's the $2.
Sorry, Eddie. My old supply got nabbed by the heat. The jolt will cost you 10 now.
10?
How about that?
Here.
The allowance my mom and dad were giving me wasn't enough to satisfy my needs anymore. I needed more dough, so I got a job after school.
What's the matter, Eddie?
Oh, I'm all right, Mr. Clemens. Don't worry. Mr. Clemens, I was wondering if you could give me an advance on my pay.
Today's only Wednesday. I've already given you half your pay.
But I need it, Mr. Clemens. Please!
You look funny, Eddie. Your eyes...
Get off my back, Mr. Clemens! Are you gonna give me the dough or ain't ya?
You finish the week, then you get your pay. No more advances.
I guess old man Clemens found out about the money I took, because soon after that, I was fired. I couldn't even hold down a job, and I stopped going to school altogether. I used to go downtown to the department stores and shoplift. Then I'd pawn the stuff I'd swiped. And then, straight away, I'd track down Sid and buy a jolt.
I'm sorry. So sorry.
Sid, what's happening?
I'm holding.
Nice book?
Yeah, $20 worth.
That's one fix.
One? Why, you?
Sorry, Eddie, that's the price. Take it or try a cold turkey.
I tried a cold turkey once, and only once. I was short of cash. All night long, I clung to the floor as the trembles began and the nausea swept over me. I vomited my guts out and the diarrhea poured. I felt like my insides were scratching and clawing and trying to get out. My nerve ends burned as if the flames were shooting out at me from all sides. I felt like I was on a roller coaster ride to hell. I'll never go through that again. Never. I made up my mind that night that I'd always have enough dough for my fixes. I knew I could never go through a complete withdrawal. I swiped the money for a jolt from my old man's wallet as he slept.
So, Eddie, what'd you do last night?
Oh, I had a real bad cold turkey last night, Sid. I had to steal from my pop.
The next morning, when I finally scored with Sid, I begged him.
Let me push the stuff for you, Sid. Pay me off and fix this, a percentage.
Now you're talking, Eddie. I'll speak to some people.
Thanks, Sid. You really won't regret it. Honest.
I rushed home and tore upstairs to my pad. Mom tried to corner me on the way, but I brushed her aside.
Oh, Eddie, thank God you're home.
No, Mom,
oh,
later.
Your father wanted to talk with you.
I slammed into my room and pulled open the drawer where I kept my fit.
Oh, cripes. Where is it? I had it somewhere.
Is this what you're looking for, Eddie?
Pop!
My son taking dope.
Give me that fit, Pop. Give me it!
What did we do? We gave you everything. Where did we go wrong? We sacrificed. Why, Eddie, why?
Can it, Pop? Just give me that fit.
He started to lecture me. His mouth kept opening and closing, but I didn't hear the words. I kept looking at that fit while my throat grew dry and my stomach started to heave, and the pain began like a monkey climbing up on my back, scratching and clawing as I started to get sick and dizzy.
You're through using this stuff, Eddie. I'm gonna turn you over to the police for a cure.
No! No, Pop! You don't know what you're saying!
Eddie, it's for your own good.
No!
Now that you're sick and they don't know what to
no.
do.
No!
That was yesterday. Now I lie on a sweat-soaked bed of a dismal, cheap hotel room, trembling and shivering as I wait for Sid. And then it comes, the heavy knock.
You Eddie Anderson?
You got the wrong guy, Copper.
I got the right guy, Eddie. Sid's gun was picked up right after your mom phoned us. He told us where you were.
You ain't got nothing on me, Narc. That ain't my fit. I was holding it for Sid. I don't touch the stuff.
That's your fit, Eddie. That's the fit you took from your father right before you killed him.
Killed? Killed my father?
You must have needed a fix pretty bad, Eddie. You hit him so hard with that limp, you split his head wide open. He died instantly.
No.
That's
good. No. Oh, God. Get this monkey off my back. No, no.
The night was clear, and the moon was yellow, and the leaves came tumbling.